Humping on your couch with my black boots on. Humping on your spouse with my black boots gone. Tell your mama move behind the throne. King of the South headed back to his throne.
Talk slow, move fast, look before you jump.
Hey everybody, I'm at Ace Adventure Resort for Mountain Music Festival. This is year number 8 that they have been doing this, and it makes my 7th year. There's a lot of great bands that are playing, and we may even have a couple interviews lined up. So why don't you join me as I go around the lake and around the mountaintop and show off some of the fun things that I really enjoy about it here. Join me as I go and explore and have a good time. Let's do it.
Started talking about how he has all the woolies and shit. He's like, yeah, I sold my silver deep space woolie for $600. I was like, yeah, that's about what it goes for. Like, that's the holy grail of woolies for the love band, right? It's like literally a
we walked probably 5 miles like in the first 2 hours.
I know, but like I've never been to a festival and not walked at least 10 miles.
And if I could get like a Segway, that'd be sweet.
Nah, bro.
Segway, at least a
fucking
real fun.
We just made it up to the top of the mountain. We're gonna head back over to the campsite, chill out for a little bit, straighten up things if we need to straighten up anything, then maybe head on down to the main stage area, check out the vendors, see what they've got going on, and whoever we run into in between now and then, we'll get them on the camera, hit them up, see if they want to chat. Big Something's not playing tonight, are they? They're playing tomorrow night, right? Okay, so actually, no, they are going to be playing tonight because Spafford had to cancel. Right, Spafford had to cancel, and then they've got Aqueous that's stepping in, and Big Something, and somebody else is playing together. So they're going to do like a collab, everyone at orchestra. They laughing at me back there. Check it out. Yeah, tell me. Yeah, bob up and down. Bob it. Bob it. Bob it. Bob it. There you go. So yeah, stay tuned. It's the art pavilion that is back here, and yeah, it's huge. Yeah, look here. It's main man Nate coming in hot.
What's up, buddy? Right?
What's up, dude?
Living dream.
Find anything cool?
Yeah. That's a moment. Actually, yeah. Someone to buy my pendant.
Yeah, really?
We sold that thing for $420.
Nice. Is the
kind of
change
for
the
sound check? Huh? I don't know. Just try to work with it a little bit, back and forth, back and forth. So you got to find your sense of balance a little bit, but once you start to get the hang of it, it's pretty cool. I mean, my ankles kind of hurt a little bit, but
yeah. Say after break mine. So
yeah. Hey, did you ever skate any?
A little bit.
A little bit. So it's similar.
Just the recent leg injury probably shouldn't help.
Right. And inside here, the Pigment Sanctuary. This is where the is the Pigment Sanctuary, right, Crystal? Or is it the Pigment?
Yeah,
it's not the Sanctuary anymore. It's the Pigment, what is it? Pigment Pavilion. Crystal saving me every time. At the Pigment Pavilion, this is where they do the free workshops, which is what this is. They have different workshops available that you can do, like I said, for free here. It's a lot of fun.
Just getting the workshops.
Getting the workshop in. Hey, this guy's getting in. Yeah. It's better to come in here at nighttime and get shots, yeah. Yeah, then the daytime, because it has a completely different element being in here at night. But you just don't get in the daytime. All right, everybody, we are headed down to the main stage. Ripe is getting ready to play. After that, I believe we've got... we've got a special appearance by my brother, Drew. Drew, say what's up.
Hey, what's up, everybody?
Hey. So we're going to go down the main stage, see what's going on. Here, let me check and see who's actually playing. So, Ripe is right now. Coming up next, we've got Galactic, and then after that, finishing out the night on the main stage is Talk, Paper, Scissors. I'm really looking forward to seeing that. Of course, that's the members of Talk, some members of Doom Flamingo, and another band, I can't remember. But that's gonna be real cool. Being at the Strange Stage tonight for the late night set at 2:30 is lit. So that's gonna be cool too. But until then, we're going down to the main stage.
Rachel Rouse and the Pagan.
2022, bro. We got Ripe on the stage. Man, they have got enough soul for all of us out here tonight. Man, you guys got to come 2023. You all got to check out Ripe. You all got to come and just, bro.
Like Drew said, we've got Ripe on stage right now. Coming up next is Galactic, followed by Talk Paper Scissors here at the main stage at Mountain Music Festival here at Ace Adventure Resort. Stay tuned. Y'all, so Ripe just finished up on the main stage. We're getting ready to head up to the Mad Tea Party and check things out. Come and see it.
We're gonna go back here and we're gonna see a bunch of crazy lights and talk to a bunch of cool people. It's just gonna be a different experience. It's one of those things that you can do if you just want to get into something different, you know what I mean? Instead of just walking around the festival grounds and trying to meet up with your friends and having, you know, watching the fire dancers and the hula hoopers and all the vendors and all that. You can just come up here if you want to, if you're feeling overwhelmed. For the Mad Tea Party, it's mad with two D's. It's double destructive. It's double destructive. We're gonna go in here and we're gonna have a fantastic time. We're gonna sip some tea. We're gonna see some good people. We're gonna have some good vibes. But we're just going to soak in it. We're just going to soak in it. It's one of the best parts of Mountain Music Fest, just to be able to come up here and just be a part of everything. Let's go. Come on. Let's do it.
Something. So last night I was talking to the people that actually built the Mad Tea Party here, and they were saying that how when they first started doing this a few years ago, they would try to go down here around the main stage and get people to come up here and be like, hey, come check out the tea party, come see what we got going on. But it wasn't as lit up, or it wasn't as, you know, as viewable as it is now. You can't really see good here, but it is all lit up here back on the hillside. Yeah, people actually thought that they were like cops, undercover cops, trying to get them to come up here and drink this, you know, funky tea. But in all reality, they're just good people, and it's just plain tea. So
I'll give you a cigarette right now. Peer pressure, trying to peer pressure Crystal into drinking tea. She's afraid. It's the Mad Hatter tea party, so you know, you never know what's actually in the tea.
Right. Well, it's not gonna be anything to make you drink.
But if there's one thing that I do have to say as far as the Mad Hatter tea party, I'm not a fan of tea myself, but this specific brew at the Mad Hatter party, man, it's smooth. It's a good, warm, crisp type of...
You can talk it up all you want, but I guarantee you that Sam's Choice Orange Pecan.
It's...
I guarantee it.
It might just be because I'm at where I'm at, but... This tea, I call it Mr. Tea, because it's strong. It wants to make a statement. It's good. Oh, it'll do more than that. It'll keep you going for 3 days at a festival.
It'll keep you up for 3 days at a festival.
3 days at a festival. This Mad Hatter tea that you have underneath this tent with all these people and these good vibes. It does sound like that. It does sound like that. Mike Grass, I want you to do this on camera. I want you to take a sip of this tea.
Search and response. Whenever you drink tea, you gotta drink it with your pinky up.
Take two.
Oh yeah, here you go, sir. Cameraman needs his beer. It's a pretty comfortable environment in here. You can come in here and relax and just zen out, enjoy yourself as well. It's got a really nice ambiance to it. And also, you've got one of the most killer views of the back of the canopy right here, and not the stage, actually. So they need a spot that's actually like cleared out so they can see a direct view to the stage. That'd be nice. Some great shots as well, so yeah, head back to the campsite. We'll be back here soon.